distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you on behalf of ICIPE to this first East African Bioeconomy Conference, which we are holding virtually today and tomorrow. If it were not for this COVID pandemic crisis, we would have met in person. While we recognize the difficulties, the difficult times the pandemic has brought to lives, economies around the world, we also see new opportunities and new ways of coping with adverse situations. We are grateful that digital technology is enabling us to continue meetings. Just as digital technology has transformed the way we do things today, sustainable economy, we believe, will also shape our future. We are co-hosting this conference with the East African Science and Technology Commission and partners under the Bioinnovate Africa program. Bioinnovate Africa is our flagship initiative, generously supported by the government of Sweden through SIDA since 2010. With Bioinnovate Africa, we demonstrate that scientists, policymakers, industry partners, and others can work together to link bioscience research ideas, technologies, and inventions directly to business and the market. It is our belief and our way to show how investment in research, capacity building in science can lead to economic growth, social development, and other areas of development in the long run. Several players are coming together in this conference, including government officials, scientists, innovators, entrepreneurs, investors, and civil society actors to discuss a strategy for sustainable bioeconomy development in East Africa and beyond. We see sustainable bioeconomy as one of the means for Africa to contribute to the UN development, sustainable development goals of 2030. It is a good model for balancing trade-offs between economic development, environmental sustainability, and social inclusion, which are key tenets of the African Union Agenda 2063, as well as the Science, Technology, and Innovation Strategy for Africa 2024. With it is abundant resources, a sustainable bioeconomy offers many opportunities for Africa to diversify its economy and ensure active participation of all sectors, including men, women, and youth. It is a chance for Africa to innovatively exploit its biological resources into commercial ventures that will lead to inclusive growth and social development. ICIPE's research is basically putting science behind Africa's rich natural biological sciences and resources. And just to give you a couple of examples so that it's not just talk, in 2013, end of 2013, understanding the use of insects for in the food and feed arena, ICIPE established a program basically to utilize Africa's rich insect biodiversity and convert them into high quality protein for livestock feed. Conventionally, livestock feed protein comes from soybean, from fish meal, from other conventional sources that normally could have been used as food for humans. Today, I'm very happy to tell you that we, together with our private sector partners, and we developed a number of procedures, mass reading protocols, processing protocols, analyzed the nutritional content of these insects, and today we have managed to replace at least 4% of Kenya's livestock protein needs with insect feed, insect protein. And our target is to continue doing that. And in the next few years, we intend to replace Kenya's livestock need, protein need, feed need by 40% with insect feed instead of soya and fish meal. And this year, we have published our discovery that a naturally existing microbe in Western Kenya can actually block malaria transmission when it is established in a mosquito in a symbiotic way. All these examples show what Africa can do using its natural products. We have also now using insects, edible insects, as sources of rich oil that are rich in antioxidants, that are rich in omega and other high quality products. And we believe that insect oils can, in the future, in the near future, would be the source of oil, fulfilling the multi-million, billion dollar oil market in the world for both cosmetic industry and for edible oil. So our potential is huge. Africa's potential is massive in this arena. ICIPA's vision and strategy in 2020 to 2025 embraces key components of sustainable bioeconomy. The center is actively involved in scientific research, capacity building, and innovation to deliver products that are environmentally safe and healthy. Our integrated pest management strategies are based on naturally occurring microorganisms and plants. We are leading research and product development in insects for food and feed, as I have indicated, and other uses. Our multidisciplinary team of scientists use newer techniques in chemistry, biology, molecular biology, computer science, and engineering to create models that help us predict movement of invasive pests, vectors of pathogens, and design appropriate control strategies. ICIPA therefore looks forward to active engagement with governments and private sector players in the region and regional economic blocs such as the East African Economic Community to build sustainable bioeconomy for the prosperity of the continent and the world at large. This pandemic has exposed the fragility of even the most advanced economies. It has demonstrated the fragility of our way of life, and a strong investment in science and research, building resilient bioeconomies, building and nurturing our ecosystems may help prevent future disasters, because this pandemic will not be the last. And we will see, if not in our lifetime, but in our children's and grandchildren's time, other pandemics and disasters. If we don't take care of climate change, if we don't take care of our natural ecosystems and our natural resources. So we thank our partners, the East African Community, through the East African Commission for Science and Technology, the Stockholm Environmental Institute, and several other partners for this conference. And last but not least, we thank the government of Sweden through SIDA for supporting all our efforts to establishing a strong bioeconomy across Africa. We look forward to productive engagement over the next couple of days, and I wish you a very productive conversation in this important area. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day, and we apologize for the technical glitch again.